joining us on Zoom for Max's service. I have muted all of you. If you want to unmute yourselves to say hello to one another, that would be fine, but I will mute you all as soon as it starts, okay? Let me know if you need anything, if anything is wrong, if you can't hear, if you can't see. You can just send me a chat if you can, okay?
I want to thank everyone for being here today. I want to thank you all for the journey you made and for showing up. If you have a cell phone, if you could silence that at this point so that we don't have any interruptions in our service. Our service is going to begin on page 2. And our hymn takes up 2 pages. And welcome to everyone on Zoom. You can hear me okay? Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy. He comforts us in all our sorrows so that we can comfort others. Thanks be to God.
I see the stars.
Please be seated. The Apostle Paul writes, "When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his." The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother in Christ, Max. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so that we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I just have to say that Mr. Max, as I called him, would want us to remember that this is a celebration of life. All right, I'm going to say it one more time. This is a celebration of life.
Yes.
Mr. Max lived 96 years. And he lived his life. And so we're sad that we won't see him again. But we're sitting in the house of God. And so let us remember that we are here to celebrate the goodness of God and the goodness we know of God in the life of Mr. Max. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right. Before I read the obituary, I'm going to read a tribute from the family from the U.S. and the British Virgin Islands, sent by Mr. Max's niece, Rosie Foy. Growing up, we always heard our dad speaking about his eldest son, Max. We were able to meet him, and oh, what a grand meeting that was. Ever since then, we kept in touch and reacquainted when we traveled to New York. But contact was not as vibrant in more recent years. What we knew of our brother is that he was a loving and kind person, always eager to hear the updates of our family. He had an amazing memory, as things that faded in our memory were always very present in his. Max's love for family was unequivocal. He could recall the names and happenings in the lives of his nieces and nephews, and his infectious laughter resounded when he learned of their successes. He has lived a great yet gentle life, deep in his faith and love for God. He was an encourager. To his dear wife, Anita, his children, and the rest of the family, we extend our sincere condolences to you. You will always be in our prayers and best thoughts. Farewell to an illustrious brother and son of St. John and the British Virgin Islands and New York. We are comforted by the assurance of God's promise to welcome home his own. Lovingly submitted by Rosie on behalf of the family in the British Virgin Islands. Mr. Max Charleswell was born in the United States Virgin Islands to the late Mabel Iantha Wells and Captain Milford Granville Charwell. Now I have to say, do you notice that it doesn't say Charleswell? It says Charwell. Because in the Caribbean, Charwell and Charleswell are the same thing. Amen? He grew up on the island of St. John, living in Cruz Bay. After his schooling, he worked at the historic Caneel Bay Resort and was the local postman, where he was known as Mr. Max to the youngsters. In the early 50s, he moved to St. Thomas. His first daughter, Eliza, was born before he enlisted in the United States Army, where he served from 1953 to 1955. Upon receiving an honorable discharge from the military, Max relocated to New York. In the early 60s, Max met Elaine Johnson, whom he would date and marry. From that marriage came his sons, Max Jr., Eric, and his daughter, Lisa. Mr. Max was a devoted employee working for Axelrod Associates, an advertising company in New York City. After Axelrod Associates closed its doors, Max became an associate at Bruno Scheidt's Import and Export Company, where he worked until his retirement. In the 1970s, Max would find himself single again. He reconnected with a friend he made when he first came to New York when attending the Virgin Islands dances that her father gave. They had a connection then, but life took them in different directions. Mr. Max knew that he would make sure that this reconnection would be lasting. His friend, Anita Sewer, would become his significant other. They married on July 28, 1979, where Max became the bonus dad to Russell and Tarina. Max and Anita had a love that made them inseparable until he entered his internal rest. Mr. Max was a proud father of his children and grandchildren, whom he loved dearly. He was a devoted member of his church because he was sure about how good God was to him. He served faithfully on the church board and as an usher until his health prevented him. He was also a member of the Rybrook Senior Citizen Center. You could always count on him to have a smile to greet you and a word to make you laugh. What Mr. Max will also be remembered for was the pride he took in gardening. He kept his lawn green, grew vegetables that he used for his gourmet Caribbean cooking, and kept the front beautiful, the front of his house beautiful with annual flowers and clean from any leaves or debris that dared to come in front of his home. Mr. Charleswell is survived by his devoted wife, Anita Charleswell, his beloved children, Eliza Scatliff, Max M. Charleswell Jr., Lisa R. Diaz and her husband, Mario, Eric E. Charleswell and his wife, Sherry, his children in love, Russell Fulmore and his husband, Victor Fulmore, Tarina Armstrong and her husband, Ronald Armstrong, grandchildren, Leroy Scatliff, Lenore Scatliff, Jessica R. Aponte, Ashley V. Diaz, Eric E. Charleswell II, and Caitlin Armstrong. Great-grandchildren, Mason Aponte, Peyton Aponte, Cameron Aponte, Lennon Aponte, Niger Scatliff, and Makai Scatliff. Max had many siblings. Those who are deceased are Kenneth Charwell, Greenville Charwell, Lou Penn, Alvin Charwell, Mertice Charwell, and Eunicia Dawson. Those who are still with us are Octavia George, Mona Hendrickson, Berenicia Lake, Benay A. Foy, Rosemary Flax, Rowena May Lewis, Kipling Charwell, Amon Charwell, Burton Charwell, Naomi Smith. He also has a myriad of nieces and nephews. Mr. Max Charleswell will be missed by his family, his friends, his church, and his community, but his spirit will live on through the memories of all the wonderful times had with him. For this, we give God thanks. Lovingly submitted, the family. Amen. Will you now read with me the 23rd Psalm, which can be found in your bulletin? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
A reading from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, the 15th chapter. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability. This mortal body must put on immortality. When this imperishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in a victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
In addition to the beautiful garden that Max had at his home, he had a beautiful garden here, which we just missed. It just faded. Maybe appropriately, we just said goodbye to the roses and the irises, the stunning flowers outside that we've all been enjoying for about a month now. We just said goodbye to those, and we remember them, and we remember Max every time we see that beautiful garden. If anyone needs to cool down or get some water, there is a water fountain just as you're going past to the bathrooms. So if you need water, please ask someone to get you a cup of water. We want everyone to stay cool and hydrated. We have about 30 people on Zoom, and it's wonderful to see, and I'm sure they're in many different places. I see some infants and some people outside, inside, many places. If you're able to rise with me in body or spirit, and if you can join with me in the gospel acclamation, alleluia, when I am lifted up, I will draw all people to myself, alleluia. The good news according to John, the 11th chapter, glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away, and many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world, the gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Thanks to Reverend Stephanie Duzant for her words encouraging us to remember that this is a time to give thanks and to celebrate. I draw great strength from those words, as usual. But this is hard. This is a big loss for Max's family, for his church, for his neighbors, for his community. At times like this, we realize how important each and every member is to the life of the church, how each person contributes in a way no one else can. I've heard a couple of people say that they're feeling this more deeply than they expected. It may seem unfair, but we usually feel a loss more or less based on a person's age or how sudden the death was. People should be saying he lived a long life, but it feels like many of us were not ready. All the things that should have prepared us for this, it still feels like we're not ready. His lovely Anita, she carries a piece of heaven with her wherever she goes, and she brings it to each of us. She doesn't experience the separation between heaven and earth the way most of us mere mortals do. She places herself in the everlasting arms. The arms that hold us come what may and strengthen us in all things. She bears that strength to us, for us, and shines that faithfulness for us. Max's going from us leaves us with a hole. We are told by Scripture that God feels the loss of any one of us, that if one sheep has wandered off, God must go and find them. We say that Max has returned to his Creator, his Heavenly Father. But we are never really separated from our Creator. Our Heavenly Father has not ever left us. We experience life as existence on our own when we are not appreciating how God is with us always and everywhere. Amen. Still, we see through a dark glass dimly, and now Max sees God face to face. None of us can fully live out our calling to be faithful and trusting. Jesus routinely says to his disciples, "Oh, you of little faith." People who saw Jesus face to face, they were not consistent in their following. But a little faith is all we need. God more than makes up for what we lack in faith. Max's leaving is felt keenly by many people. For us at church, he was a constant presence, he and Anita, and also a warm and genial and welcoming soul. With Father's Day next week, there will be many people who looked upon him as a father figure. As a father figure, as a kind of an uncle for many. He kind of had that bearing about him. He liked to kid, he liked to tease, but he did it in the gentlest manner I've ever seen. There was a steadiness that was reassuring. He was attentive to people, listened, asked questions. You felt that he cared. He was fun. He was fun in a way that made you feel like he wanted you to feel good. There are, of course, many sides to a man. One of the things we miss when someone takes their leave is all the stories that we didn't get to ask about. I remember Max telling me about one of his first experiences coming to the States. Leaving the U.S. Virgin Islands, he joined the Army, and it brought him to Texas. At that point in his life, he had never experienced segregation. But it was, of course, alive and well in Texas. He experienced it with bewilderment. It was an alien concept to him, separating people because of the color of their skin. He was not raised like that, with signs, with people scolding you. Fortunately, he had Army buddies, who, as white men seeing their friend turned away, decided that they would not go in either. The Army itself had only recently been integrated. I think part of how we will miss Max is all the praying that we've done for him, lifting him up in prayer week after week. God did not need to be reminded of Max's need. God did not need to be reminded of Max's deserving. Praying for Max, that is God's way of moving our hearts, making us mindful, drawing us closer together. And now, for all the prayers, we feel the loss all the more. They say grief is the price you pay for love. And when you fill your love with prayer, earnest, loving prayers, the grief then is all the more. Let us pray for each other now. Pray without ceasing. Let us pray that God bring an end to things that separate people. Let us pray that God make us more than eager to learn about others, to ask questions, to share a warm, mischievous, Max-like smile, to help somebody each day and make the world a little less crazy, to plant roses and irises and tomatoes, to make a special meal for someone, to bring joy and laughter and love. Amen. This is a day to celebrate, for all of us, our baptism. We continue on page 6, remembering the creed in which we were baptized. Either as infants or as adults, we were asked these questions. Our sponsors answered for us, or we answered ourselves. Let us rise, whether in body or spirit. God has made us one people through baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We shared the creed on the screen for people watching on Zoom so they could recite it with us. As Lutherans, we know that the oldest Lutheran church, the oldest Lutheran building in the Western Hemisphere is in the Virgin Islands, and we celebrate that heritage. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit your people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy. Grant to us who are still on our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, in your mercy. Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy. Grant us grace to entrust Max to your never-failing love, which sustains him in this life. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, and remember him according to the favor you bear for your people. Lord, in your mercy. Please be seated. Now we get to some celebrating. We're always so honored and glad with the music that we have each week with our organist, Claudia, and for our maestro, our Grammy Award-winning maestro, Chip Gall. We're always glad when Kia is here to sing with us. We're so glad that she's returning. And we're so glad for our special band. We have Alan Johnson, St. Paul's Confirmation Class of 1983. Nicholas Troutman, Mo Jammy, and Jay Sweeney. Oh. Lutherans can be kind of shy in church, but I think we should show them some love. Let's show them some love. And again, as you are able, let us rise, whether in body or spirit. I invite you to join in praying together with me the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You are the strength of those who labor. You are the rest of the blessed dead. We rejoice in the company of your saints. We remember all who have lived in faith, all who have peacefully died, and especially those most dear to us who rest in you. Give us in time our portion with those who have trusted in you and have striven to do your holy will. To your name, with the church on earth and the church in heaven, we ascribe all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Max. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May God perpetually shine upon him. The music, the lyrics for the song, the next song, is in your bulletin if you want to sing along with our band. You may be seated.
Oh,
and Claudia are going to play Jesus Savior Pilot Lou one more time. Family invites everyone to join them for a reception at T&J at 1 p.m.
Thank you. see me 6 out of 7.
I have you on August 24th. I just spoke with a client.
It's going to be a great week. Same day.
Cool.
So we're all good. Yeah, I'm going to see you.
Oh, great.